Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and iOS 14.7 has been out to the public for a few days now, and also iOS 15 Beta 3 has been out for a week and a half or so. And so I wanted to go over it, give it my full review as far as iOS 14.7, since it's finally out to the public, talk about the YouTube community poll, the comments, and more. And the first thing is, this week Apple released new firmware for the AirPods Pro. Now, this is in beta, and I wouldn't recommend normally installing it. People were asking me, where is my video on this? And the reason I didn't release one is it's not easy to install. So not only do you need a profile, what you need to do is go to your settings, go to general, then you'll go to your profile, and you'll see here's the AirPods profile. Now, this profile is unfortunately not the only step. What you actually have to do is go on a Mac and then use Xcode to actually install this. So it's not a simple process, and I wouldn't really recommend it to most people. So there's not really anything new as far as the AirPods go, and it's not worth installing unless you need to develop for them specifically right now. Maybe in the future there'll be some updates for that as well. Now the next thing is spatial audio. It's finally available in India. So for those of you that have been messaging me saying that where is spatial audio, well, it's finally here and available in India as well. It's rolling out. If you don't have it already, you should start seeing it soon, and it sounds great. If you haven't heard it, I would highly recommend you check it out. Now, as far as a couple new features I wanted to go over first is, if we go into photos, someone sent this to me when they were restoring their phone on iOS 15 Beta 3. It says restore in progress, an estimated 400 megabytes will be required to finish restoring your apps and data. This shows up, which is really nice. It gives you an idea of what's going on, and it's just more information if you're restoring your phone. So that's something that's new in iOS 15 Beta 3. Also, something I mentioned before is in weather. So if you go into weather, and under weather, if you scroll down to the map or temperature here under the map, one thing to note is if you go under precipitation and you see the forecast at the bottom, this is based on your zoom level. Depending on your zoom, it actually goes to a 12-hour forecast, or it can actually go to a different forecast. So maybe we'll go into Charleston here, and it gives you the next hour forecast. So it's very dependent based on what zoom level you're at. This is something that's a little bit new. Now, another thing that's new in iOS 15 Beta 3 is a new splash screen. So it's not really any new feature, but for some reason, when I went into reminders again, it presented another splash screen. I've seen this before, but then it popped back up and it says organize with tags, optimize with smart lists, and lots more. So that's something that's new, but not really exciting. And I'm not sure why it's showing up again, but it's there. Now, as far as iOS 14.7, well, that's been out for a little while now, and I've been using it as a release candidate and then a final version, and it's been really great. And a lot of people are saying that performance is much better than iOS 14.6, whether that be on the latest phones or on an older phone. People with iPhone 6S Plus, 6S, or 7 are saying that performance in general has been improved from 14.6 to 14.7, which is a great thing. However, there's still issues with it, such as playlist issues, maybe not showing a proper count as far as the overall playlist, and also music is glitchy when the history doesn't update for some reason. So the history was supposed to be fixed, sometimes it just doesn't update as you would expect. Also, unlock with Apple Watch isn't working for some. Maybe you're using a mask, for example, and trying to unlock your phone using your Apple Watch. For some people, that's not working, and that seems to be more on Touch ID phones. So if you have a Touch ID phone and it's not working, Apple is aware of this, and it looks like they're probably working on iOS 14.7.1 to remedy this. So whether or not we see this within a couple of weeks is hard to say, but I would expect some sort of update as far as iOS 14.7, since that's still a problem out there. So that's definitely an issue. As far as iPadOS 14.7, it's been pretty good. So I'm using it on the iPad Air 4. It seems to be nice and fast. Performance is pretty good, and battery life seems to be decent overall. There's not really any differences. Apple did release it a few days after iOS 14.7 for some reason, but iPadOS 14.7 has the same features, everything that's exactly the same, except for the USB-C to 3.5 millimeter headphone jack or adapter. That's been fixed. That's the only thing different in iPadOS. Otherwise, it performs great, works great on older devices, and really has no issues for most people. So it seems to be a pretty solid update. Now, as far as iOS 15 Beta 3 and using it over the past week and a half, I've been using it on my main phone. I'll talk more about battery life on both devices in a moment. The number one complaint is Spotlight search not working. So when you go to search, maybe you're searching an app and it's not working. It's working fine for me. If I search for Apple, and hit go, you'll see that it's finding the different apps and things like that. So it is working fine for me, but not for everyone for some reason. So that's the number one complaint. Now, some people have said that CarPlay is an issue with iOS 15 Beta 3 still. It could be issues with the GPS not working properly through the car. And specifically, someone mentioned Honda, and then also just music not working as you would expect. So there's definitely a ways to go with iOS 15 Beta 3. And one issue I found that was kind of curious is the alarm. So if you go into the clock and maybe you have a sleep alarm set and it goes to wake you up and you tap snooze on your iPhone, it doesn't snooze on the Apple Watch properly. I've had this happen for the past few days and the watch isn't snoozing. So I'll have to hit it separately. It will go off again on the watch and I'll have to tap either snooze or end or shut off the alarm. So that's something I'm seeing specifically. Also, some people are saying that the taptic engine, the vibration engine within the iPhone, is actually over-vibrating or sort of vibrating so hard that it makes a loud noise when calls come in. So that could be an issue. And they've had those issues in the past, so they definitely could fix that with software. And then also people are still having issues with Twitter crashing and other apps such as banking apps, maybe just not working properly, maybe crashing, and many of them seem to be German banks. However, the app developer will have to update those, and typically as we get closer to the release of iOS 15, we'll see more of that where they'll become more stable, and Apple definitely could fix something on their end as well. Also, another huge issue seems to be Bluetooth. Bluetooth continues to be an issue not only on iOS 14.7, but also iOS 15 betas. I don't know if they changed something, but some people are saying that their AirPods don't connect properly, where they'll actually have to manually connect the AirPods. And then other people are just saying that they'll disconnect after 15 seconds or so, music will stop playing. So there's still issues going on with Bluetooth overall. I'm not exactly sure what's causing it, but it seems to be a long-running issue that they need to resolve at this point. Also, Wi-Fi has been an issue for some, and I don't know if this is router specific, but someone mentioned Nest Wi-Fi having an issue. So there's definitely some issues that need to be resolved there, where that dropping connections. Now, Nest could update their Wi-Fi routers as well to fix this issue, but it seems like it's an ongoing issue. Of course, there's green tint, and some people say, why do you mention this every time? And that's because Apple fixed it in late August for the iPhone 11 Pro and 11 Pro Max. So I still expect them to resolve that issue in the long term. Now, as far as heat of both devices, with iOS 15 Beta 3, some people do complain of heat. iOS 14.7 seems to have less of those issues. Just after using it for a couple days, it fixes or finishes doing all of the background processes. It seems to be better overall than iOS 15. iOS 15 is an early beta, so it seems to make sense that there would be a bunch of background processes going on. So I would give it a few more days if you're on iOS 14.7 and you just installed it, but heating overall seems to be better. In fact, earlier today when I was trying to record, I couldn't record because my phone got too hot on iOS 15 Beta 3. It was too warm outside, about 90 degrees Fahrenheit. I had the screen brightness all the way up, and the phone got hot enough where it dimmed the display. So there's definitely some heat issues going on from time to time. Now, as far as iPadOS 15 Beta 3, I've been using it full time on my iPad Pro 12.9 from 2021. This is the M1 version, and it's been pretty flawless as far as bugs go. The main complaint I have with it is battery life. So I haven't had any apps crash, although I don't use banking apps on here. So I've had a few little things in Safari, but mostly it's been pretty solid. However, battery life has been not so great. It's basically getting me 5 to 6 hours of screen on time. So over the last 10 days, here's yesterday, I got 5 hours and 33 minutes of screen on time, 1 hour and 20 minutes of screen off time, and used almost 100% of my battery. So right now it's just not great screen on time, and that seems to be the main thing with the iPad. Hopefully they'll improve that in the future. With iOS 14.7, many people are saying that battery life has significantly improved over 14.6 as well. Most people have this experience, although there are some that are having the opposite experience, but I generally say give it a few days and see if it improves, and then check your settings and see if something's using your battery. Because in general, it's a much better update than iOS 14.6 as far as that goes, according to most people in the comments. So a lot of people are saying they're not having any issues with battery life as far as 14.7 goes. While I haven't been using it 100% of the time, I've been using iOS 15 on my 12 Pro Max. A couple of you have sent me your battery life so I could share it with you. One with an iPhone 12 Pro Max and one with an iPhone 11. So Cameron sent me the iPhone 12 Pro Max, and you can see 100% usage got him 9 hours and 55 minutes of screen on time. That's pretty good overall. So that's not bad. He sent me another one where the day before he used a little over 50% of his battery, and he scored 6 hours and 44 minutes of screen on time and 2 hours and 22 minutes of screen off time. So that's pretty good. And another day, again, about over a little over 6 hours. Now, David sent in a screenshot from his iPhone 11, and you can see here he had 4 hours and 2 minutes of screen on time, 10 minutes of screen off time, and used about 50% of his battery life. So that's pretty good. Almost 8 hours of screen on time using music and Facebook. Facebook does typically drain a lot of battery. Music's pretty good, but that's decent battery life overall, especially on an iPhone 11. Now, as far as iOS 14.7.1 release, I talked a little bit about that before. I would expect it pretty soon, within a week or two, to remedy that issue with unlocking your phone. Hopefully it's just a minor bug, but it doesn't look like we're going to get another beta, at least based on what people have found so far. So we could see an iOS 14.8, but right now it looks like we'll just have minor updates until a final release of iOS 15, which should be out in mid to late September. As far as when to expect iOS 15 Beta 4, I would expect it sometime around Wednesday of this coming week. Since we had iOS 15 Beta 3 on the 14th, or around that date, I would say that probably the 28th, usually within 2 weeks, we'll have iOS 15 Beta 4, and then we'll have some new features, changes, bug fixes, and more. So that seems to make the most amount of sense. Now that leads me to, should you install iOS 14.7? And I would say if you haven't already, that absolutely. And the main reason is due to security vulnerability. If new features and bug fixes aren't that big of a deal to you, security vulnerabilities definitely should be, and you can see all of the security patches on Apple's security website, where they patched a number of vulnerabilities from Wi-Fi that I've mentioned before, where there was a Wi-Fi bug fix, to Core Audio, Find My, and you can see Find My says that they fixed a malicious application that may be able to access Find My data. They patched that and fixed it with a permission issue, which was addressed with improved validation. So they mentioned this, and I'll link this in the description, but you can see there's a number of fixes in this update to improve security overall. So if you haven't updated, maybe you're even on iOS 13 versions, I would definitely recommend installing this as it fixes a lot of those security bugs. Plus, you'll get all of the bug fixes and more. As far as iOS 15 Beta 3, well, if you're not on iOS 15 betas yet, I would probably hold off until iOS 15 Beta 4 comes out, as it tends to be much more stable at that point. So just wait for that to release, and I think you'll have a much better experience, and you'll gain some extra features and things like that. So if you want to try the public beta out, I would just wait until it comes out a little bit later. Now, there's a couple things to note about some news, and the first thing is iPad mini should be coming, hopefully, this year, later this year, some people are saying. I know a lot of people are looking forward to that. So those of you that don't want the iPad Air, this might be a little bit too big. We could have an iPad mini that looks very similar to it. Some are saying it's going to be mini LED. Some are saying that it won't be, but at least we'll get a new iPad Air at some point with a redesign, it looks like, with a similar Touch ID sensor to the iPad Air. That makes a lot of sense. Also, the replacement to the MacBook Air is said to be coming probably not until 2022. Some people were saying by the end of this year, but it looks like we're going to get one probably in 2022 instead with mini LED. And also, iPhone 13 is just a couple months away, so they're production is really ramped up, and apparently they're ordering more than they did last year. So we should see a lot of those with a very similar design to what we have now, but with some better cameras. And I'm really hoping for that 120 hertz ProMotion display. That seems to be the big thing with the iPhone 13 or 12S, depending on what Apple calls it. I think they're going to call it iPhone 13, although maybe they'll just call it iPhone this year or the 2021 iPhone. We'll have to wait and see. But let me know what you think about that in the comments below. Now let's take a look at the YouTube community poll and some of the comments. Now we'll go into YouTube, and on the community page, you can see at the time of this video, there are 23,000 votes. So I'm really appreciative to everyone that voted and commented. There's 479 comments, and it's about to get a little bit noisy out here. So hopefully you can't hear the cicadas and other bugs too loud, but let me know if you like these outdoor videos in the comments below. Now, the first thing is there's 58% of you that are on iOS 14.7, 25% of you are on iOS 15 Beta 3, 12% of you have not updated yet, so you're on iOS 14.6 or older, and 5% of you are using iOS 12 or older or Android. So that's a huge amount that's already updated to iOS 14.7, so it's pretty incredible how quickly people will update. Now let's take a look at some of the comments. So we'll take a look at 5 or 10 of them. It's getting a little bit noisy out here all of a sudden, but we'll sort by newest first. And there's 479 comments. That's where I got all the information for this video. So that's incredible how many people have commented. So I really appreciate it. Sergey said, everything is okay, but somehow it was also the same on RC. My Geekbench score in multi-core section is way below average when single core is okay. I'm using iPhone XS Max. Battery life is okay. Make sure you're updated as far as Geekbench, but I wouldn't worry too much about that. That's just a general idea. Give it a few days and see if it improves. Kelvin H says, generally everything seems better than before, including my issue with iMessage. When I use the reply option in a long texted thread, it still snags. However, the snagging is way less persistent. In addition, my iPhone 12 Pro Max now seems to charge quite faster. All okay on my iPhone SE. I use it much every day. Charge overnight. Battery seems okay. Rosetta says, battery seems to drain faster on iOS 14.7 on my iPhone 12. Sad. But right below that, Eric H says, battery life for me seems to be incredible. Knock on wood for that. It was bad the first 2 days after updating, but now it's great. And that's generally what I tell people, is give it a couple days and it usually improves greatly. Lucky says, I'm on iOS 14.7 using an iPhone 12. So far it's working okay and battery life is good for me compared to iOS 14.6. However, I do still get an issue where my music stops playing whenever I open Facebook and not sure if it's a bug. It used to happen even when I was on 14.6. That could happen if it senses a video is there and it wants to try and play that. I've seen that before. Amon says, my issue is still on my AirPods Pro connection. They sometimes pause a second while playing music, video, and even long voice notes. So please, Mr. Aaron, advise them to improve that. Otherwise, other features are okay and normal. I'm using it on the iPhone 11 Pro. Kapil says, battery life was better than iOS 14.6 on my iPhone 11. Performance was the same as before. No complaints. Michael says, I updated the 14.7 when it came out. I haven't noticed any difference whatsoever. Using an iPhone XS, I honestly forgot the update was released. Rick says, iOS 14.7 here. I believe battery life has improved. As for performance, it seems slightly better. Overall, much better than iOS 14.6. Would recommend. I'm on an iPhone XR. Edry Louis Plata says, iOS 15 Beta 3 is great. I'm using the iPhone 11. Surfshark VPN updated their app, so VPN works now on iOS 15. The only bug I have is the AirPods. Every time I put them on, I have to turn off Bluetooth and turn it back on. Battery life is pretty good. Yash says, phone feels much smoother and responsive, and battery too seems to be doing fine. Keep up the good work. Thank you. Tobias Mikalski, hopefully I'm saying that properly. I have iOS 14.7 and runs flawlessly. I'm so glad that I changed to iPhone in December of last year. Aiden says, I've been using this since it was released officially. I must say I had better battery life on 14.6. My iPhone glitches sometimes since updating. I'm using iPhone 12 Pro Max. Also having keyboard issues. Please, Aaron, what would you advise? I've been watching your videos from day one and trust your judgment. Thank you. As far as the keyboard issues, if you're using the Apple stock keyboard, I would just try and reboot, see if it fixes it. Otherwise, the only thing you can do is, in the worst case scenario, is restore everything and start over or just wait for another update, unfortunately. There's not a whole lot you can do for that. And then finally, JP Sullivan says, iOS 14.7 has been working fine on my iPhone XR. Keep up the good work. And so that's everything for iOS 14.7 and iOS 15 Beta 3. I'm looking forward to iOS 15 Beta 4, of course, with maybe some changes as well, and maybe even an iOS 14.7.1, but we'll have to wait and see what Apple does as far as that goes. If you found anything else new, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. And if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. If you haven't subscribed already though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.